So, fellow Christians, those who rely on the Bible, the Holy Bible, as the Word of God, one truth exposes a thousand lies. So today, what we're going to do is we're going to go through about 145 plus verses revealing the operation and constructs of God's created earth. So things that we're going to cover today is going to include: earth is a circle, earth does not move, earth has ends, earth has corners, earth has pillars, earth has a face, from the top of a tree, from the top of a mountain, from the sun moves, sun anomalies, earth before the sun, we'll do a recap, the most obvious deception, and additional resources. And something that I'm sure you see right off the bat here is that the earth, you know, the Bible is going to show that the earth is a circle. It has ends and corners. And I'm sure that's a very odd concept. So I'm going to do my best to address that a little bit later, though. So let's move forward. So earth is a circle. So Isaiah 40:22. It is he that sitteth upon the circle of the earth. Now, there's a few different translations on how this word circle could be translated, but like some of it says in other passages, it'll say circle or circuit rather, or compass. But what we'll find is that when you look at the full picture, just as if you were looking at one scripture that says, you know, Jesus Christ is the Son of Man, or you know, he is the Lord, any of these are that he says, I am he who you speak of when he's addressing the woman. If you only had one verse to go off to show that Jesus Christ is Christ, he is the Messiah, it would be a very impossible feat and task. That's why we have a lot of scriptures which all corroborate with each other. Likewise, this verse right here alone could not stand upon the fact that the earth is not a sphere, but it's just one element to the full picture. So let's proceed, though. So is the globe earth a sphere or a circle? So when you look at the picture, of course, and you also see the NASA animated movie video images that they put out, and it'll look like it's rotating as a globe or a sphere. So a table with a round top, is the top a sphere or a circle? Clearly, it's a circle. So I'm just showing you that when it comes to roundness, like Obama will even say, he said in one of his speeches, I'm not sure how long ago, that science community, or something to the effect that science community has proven that, or that rather the science suggests that the earth is round. And when he says it's round, he's not lying, because a sphere or a circle, they're both round. So in any case, let's move on. So earth does not move. Zechariah 1:11, all the earth sitteth still and is at rest. Psalm 104:5, laid the foundations of the earth that it should not be moved forever. Psalm 93:1, the world also is established that it cannot be moved. Psalm 96:10, the world also shall be established that it shall not be moved. 1 Chronicles 16:30, the world also shall be stable that it not be moved. Earth has ends. So there are 35 verses in the Bible that state earth, end of the earth, or ends of the earth. Does a spherical globe have an end? And if it does, then where is it? If you were asked to explain where to locate the ends of a baseball, basketball, or soccer ball, could you? So here are the 35 verses that state end of the earth or ends of the earth. So it's Deuteronomy 28:49, Deuteronomy 28:64, Deuteronomy 33:17, 1 Samuel 2:10, Job 37:3, Job 38:13, Psalm 46:9, Psalm 48:10, Psalm 59:13, Psalm 61:2, Psalm 65:5, Psalm 67:7, Psalm 72:8, Psalm 98:3, Psalm 135:7, Proverbs 17:24, Proverbs 30:4, Isaiah 5:26, Isaiah 26:15, Isaiah 40:28, Isaiah 41:5, Isaiah 41:9, Isaiah 42:10, Isaiah 43:6, Isaiah 45:22, Isaiah 48:20, Isaiah 49:6, Isaiah 52:10, Jeremiah 10:13, Jeremiah 16:19, Jeremiah 25:31, Jeremiah 51:16, Micah 5:4, Zechariah 9:10, Acts 13:47. So the earth has corners. There are two verses in the Bible that state four corners of the earth. Does a spherical globe have a corner, let alone four of them? If it does, then where are they? If you were asked to explain where to locate four corners on a baseball, basketball, or soccer ball, could you? So here are the two verses that state four corners of the earth. Isaiah 11:12, and he shall set up an ensign for the nations, and shall assemble the outcasts of Israel, and gather together the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth. Revelation 7:1, and after these things I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding four wings of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. Earth has corners. So how is it that earth can be a circle, have ends, and four corners? I don't know exactly, but this is probably one of the best depictions of this concept that I've seen to date. Obviously, no one has actually been in outer space. I mean, just start looking at the moon landing, the evidence that it is a hoax. Quite rapidly, things start to fall apart for that whole psyop that our government did on us. So, there's a movie or a little short film you might be able to find. It's called Something Funny Happened when we went to the Moon. I think that might be the title of it. Might be worth checking out. So earth has pillars. So there are three verses in the Bible that clearly state the earth has pillars. Job 9:6, which shaketh the earth out of her place, and the pillars thereof tremble. Psalm 75:3, the earth and all the inhabitants thereof are dissolved. I bear up the pillars of it. 1 Samuel 2:8, he riseth up the poor out of the dust, and lifteth up the beggar from the dunghill, to set them among princes, and to make them inherit the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are Yahweh's, and he hath set the world upon them. So where do the pillars of the earth exist in the many pictures of the globe earth we are provided by NASA, including this image? I don't see them. So earth has a face. So there are 36 verses in the Bible that clearly state the earth has a face, not a surface. Is not what it's referring to, a face as the face of your own head, so a front, as if there could also be a back. So if you were asked to explain where to locate the face on a basketball, or a baseball, basketball, or a soccer ball, could you? If you could explain where to locate the face on the globe Earth, where would that be? Could you explain where to locate the face on a table with a top that was round? Should be pretty easy. That's the top of the table. That's the face. So earth has a face. So there are 36 verses that state the earth has a face. Genesis 1:29, Genesis 4:14, Genesis 6:1, Genesis 6:7, Genesis 7:3, Genesis 7:4, Genesis 8:9. Genesis 11:8, Genesis 11:9, Genesis 41:56, Exodus 10:5, Exodus 10:15, Exodus 32:12, Exodus 33:16, Numbers 12:3, Numbers 22:5, Numbers 22:11, Deuteronomy 6:15, Deuteronomy 7:6, 1 Samuel 20:15, 1 Kings 13:34, Job 37:12, Psalms 104:30, Jeremiah 8:2, Jeremiah 16:4, Jeremiah 25:26, Jeremiah 28:16, Ezekiel 34:6, Ezekiel 38:20, Ezekiel 39:14, Amos 9:6, Amos 9:8, Zechariah 5:3, Luke 21:35, Acts 17:26, and Revelation 21:1. Top of a tree. Daniel 4:11, the tree grew and was strong, and the height thereof reached unto heaven, and the sight thereof to the end of all the earth. Daniel 4:20, the tree that thou sawest, which grew and was strong, whose height reached unto the heaven, and the sight thereof to all the earth. So how is it possible on a globe earth to observe all the earth, let alone the end of the earth, from a treetop that reaches the highest point of the earth's atmosphere? On a flat plane earth, this is possible, however, not on a globe-shaped earth. Top of a mountain. Matthew 4:8. Again the devil taketh him, Jesus, up into an exceeding high mountain, and showeth him all the kingdoms of the world, and the glory of them. On a globe earth, it is not possible to scale any altitude high enough to view all the kingdoms of the world. So why would the devil even try? The sun moves. So how does it move? Up, down, arise, goeth down, ariseth, go down, arose, going down, rise, gone down, risen, went down, riseth. Let's see here. Sun rising, rising, rose. It's a lot of verbs. The sun apparently moves. It's not stationary, as the heliocentric model tries to make us think. It actually moves, according to the Bible. So, I mean, you know, you could maybe make the argument that all these passages that I'm about to show you was from a perspective of just some men who were just using their own perspective and not really knowing how or who the Creator is and being inspired by Him to understand the fundamentals of their creators, who is inspiring them, their creators, foundations of the earth. I have a hard time justifying that. So there's 56 verses that state the sun moves. Jonah 4:8, Nahum 3:17, Ecclesiastes 1:5, Leviticus 22:7, Deuteronomy 23:11, Joshua 8:29, 2 Samuel 3:35, Amos 8:9, Isaiah 60:20, Deuteronomy 24:15, Micah 3:6, Ephesians 4:26, Exodus 22:26, Deuteronomy 11:30, Deuteronomy 24:13. Genesis 15:12, Exodus 17:12, Deuteronomy 16:6, Joshua 1:4, Joshua 10:27, 1 Kings 22:36, 2 Chronicles 18:34, Daniel 6:14, Jeremiah 15:9, Matthew 5:45, Genesis 19:23, Exodus 22:3, James 1:11, 2 Samuel 23:4, Numbers 2:3. Joshua 12:1, Psalm 51, Psalm 113:3, Isaiah 41:25, Isaiah 45:6, Isaiah 49:10, Isaiah 59:19, Mark 16:2, Malachi 1:11, Genesis 32:31, Numbers 21:11, Numbers 34:15, Deuteronomy 4:41, Deuteronomy 4:47, Joshua 1:15, Joshua 13:5, Joshua 19:12, Joshua 19:27, Joshua 19:34. Judges 20:43, Judges 8:13, Judges 9:33, Genesis 15:17, Judges 14:18, Judges 19:14, 2 Samuel 2:24. So that's a lot of different books of the Bible, quite a few different authors, different time periods, and all of them agree that the sun moves. Sun anomalies. So there are at least 5 different passages in the Holy Bible where the sun does something very unusual. So the first is this. The sun has moved backward 10 degrees. That's Isaiah 38:8. Behold, I will bring again the shadow of the degrees which is gone down in the sundial of Ahaz, I guess that's how you say Ahaz, 10 degrees backward. So the sun returned 10 degrees, by which degrees it was gone down. So how can you return something 10 degrees if it had never moved? I mean, if it was the earth that had moved, why would the inspired writer not just say that the earth rotated backwards 10 degrees? No, it specifically says that the sun returned 10 degrees, by which degrees it was gone down. So it moved backwards. That means it was moving forward, but now it's moving backward. So number two, the sun shall no more go down, Isaiah 60:20. Thy sun shall no more go down. That means it has been going down. Why would you? That means it's been moving, and now you're going to say it's not moving. So the sun riseth not, Job 9:7, which commandeth the sun, and it riseth not. So it usually rises, but now it's not. Number four, the sun stood still and the moon stayed. Joshua 10:12-14. Then spake Joshua to Yahweh in the day when Yahweh delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel, and he said in the sight of Israel, Sun, stand thou still upon Gibeon, and thou moon in the valley of Ajalon. Verse 13, and the sun stood still and the moon stayed, until the people had avenged themselves upon their enemies. Is not this written in the book of Jasher? So the sun stood still in the midst of heaven, and haste not to go down about a whole day. And there was no day like that before it or after it, that Yahweh hearkened unto the voice of a man, for Yahweh fought for Israel. So the sun stopped moving. It stood still. Also, so did the moon, interestingly enough. And there was no other day like it before or after. So this is an anomaly. The sun is not usually standing still according to this passage. But on this particular day, it was. So this is number five. So the sun and the moon stood still again. So Habakkuk 3:11. The sun and moon stood still in their habitation. At the light of thine arrows they went down, and at the shining of thy glittering spear. Let's see here. Sorry about that. So let's go back here. So earth before sun. So earth before the sun. So when building anything, it only makes sense to build your foundation first. So what came first, the earth or the sun? Just like the chicken or the egg, or the egg or the chicken. So which came first? Day one of creation, earth is created. Genesis 1:1, in the beginning, Elohim created the heaven and the earth. Day four of creation, sun is created. Genesis 1:16, and Elohim made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. The building block of our universe, Earth, was created before the sun. All right, so let's recap. The Holy Bible states, the Earth is a circle, not a sphere. The earth does not move, let alone rotating on its axis and orbiting a path. The earth has ends, and we know that a sphere does not have ends. The earth has corners, and we know that a sphere does not have corners. The earth has pillars, and the images provided by NASA of the globe Earth do not display even one pillar. The earth has a face, which cannot be established on a sphere surface. However, a flat surface, a face, can be established. The end of the earth cannot be established while it be a spherical earth. And even if it could, from the facts of spherical trigonometry, all of the spherical earth would never be able to be seen from one location, no matter how high in altitude. However, the Holy Bible claims this to be feasible in two examples, and given the physical laws of nature, would be most likely on a flat, plane earth. Normal operation of the sun is that it moves upon the earth. God made the sun to stop and still stand still, and once it moved backward from its forward motion. The earth, being the center of the universe, was created on the first day, whereas the sun was created after the earth, and that being the fourth day. So the most obvious deception. Revelation 12:9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent, called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. Why does it matter to you, a Christian, study and grasp this most obvious deception? Simply because once you realize the most obvious deception, all other deceptions and conspiracies are no longer that far-fetched. In fact, I was having a conversation with one person, and they found it completely ridiculous to believe that millions, if not really billions of people, including Christians, could be deceived for this long and it go unnoticed, and that God would allow us to be blinded by this simple fact of our existence. And if you think about it, it's kind of a prideful approach to look at this situation. Because even if you look back at the beginning in paradise, Satan was allowed to deceive Eve. God didn't stop it. He allowed it to happen. So if he allowed it to happen in paradise, and we know that Satan rules the air here on earth right now. Yes, God is ultimately in control. But for right now, this season of time, Satan does rule the air. And he is in control in a lot of aspects right now. Nothing past which God does not give him, but yes, he is in control of a lot. And that also includes the deception of this simple fact. So real eyes, real lies.